Hello, my friend, and welcome. Welcome back. Welcome to day 24 of our 31-day journey through the Proverbs. Let me ask you a question. Do you need this as much as I need this today? Man, I really feel like I need this. Let's go ahead and dive into our text for the day. We are reading, of course, Proverbs chapter 24. And in verse 1, it says, "Don't be envious of evil men, neither desire to be with them, for their hearts plot violence and their lips talk about mischief. Through wisdom a house is built, by understanding it is established. By knowledge the rooms are filled with all rare and beautiful treasure. A wise man has great power, and a knowledgeable man increases strength. For by wise guidance you wage your war, and victory is in many advisors. Wisdom is too high for a fool. He doesn't open his mouth in the gate. One who plots to do evil will be called a schemer. The schemes of folly are sin. The mocker is detested by men. If you falter in the time of trouble, your strength is small. Rescue those who are being led away to death. Indeed, hold back those who are staggering to the slaughter. If you say, 'Behold, we didn't know this,' doesn't he who weighs the hearts consider it? He who keeps your soul, doesn't he know it? Will he not render to every man according to his work? My son, eat honey, for it is good, the droppings of the honeycomb, which are sweet to your taste. So you will know wisdom to be to your soul. If you have found it, then there will be a reward. Your hope will not be cut off. Don't lay in wait, wicked man, against the habitation of the righteous. Don't destroy his resting place. For a righteous man falls 7 times and rises up again, but the wicked are overthrown by calamity. Don't rejoice when your enemy falls. Don't let your heart be glad when he's overthrown, lest the Lord see it, and it displease him, and he turn away his wrath from him. Don't fret yourself because of evildoers, neither be envious of the wicked, for there will be no reward to the evil man. The lamp of the wicked will be snuffed out. My son, fear the Lord and the king. Don't join with those who are rebellious, for their calamity will rise suddenly. Who knows what destruction may come from them both? These also are sayings of the wise. To show partiality in judgment is not good. He who says to the wicked, 'You are righteous,' peoples will curse him and nations will abhor him. But it will go well with those who convict the guilty, and a rich blessing will come on them. An honest answer is like a kiss on the lips. Prepare your work outside and get your fields ready. Afterwards, build your house. Don't be a witness against your neighbor without cause. Don't deceive with your lips. Don't say, 'I will do to him as he has done to me. I will repay the man according to his work.' I went by the field of the sluggard, by the vineyard of the man void of understanding. Behold, it was all grown over with thorns. Its surface was covered with nettles, and its stone wall was broken down. Then I saw and considered well. I saw and received instruction. A little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to sleep. So your poverty will come as a robber, and your want as an armed man." Recognize that last bit there, echoing back to Proverbs chapter 6, I think it was, "Go to the ant, you sluggard, consider its ways and be wise." Today, what I want to do is I want to focus specifically here on verse 27, which says, "Prepare your work outside and get your fields ready. Afterwards, build your house." When I look at this verse, what it makes me think is that there is a natural and logical order to things, and you don't want to get things out of order. For example, you don't want to start building a business, for example, you don't want to put a website up for your business and then later, like, okay, well, what's the name of my business? And what's my business about? it's kind of like, yeah, you have to plan things methodically, one thing at a time. For example, what sounds more sexy? To build yourself a nice house or to get an education and then get a job or build a business? I think all you have to do is look at some of the reality TV shows to get the answer to that question. Or what sounds more appealing? To be a famous author or to be an unknown blogger for years and years? That's usually how the really famous and well-known authors get to become well-known and famous, is they blog, not anybody knowing anything about them for years and years, or write for some kind of journal. They live in obscurity before, and they do the hard work. I guess that's the point. The point is, oftentimes, we look at other people's success. We look at other people's strengths, and we want that for ourselves, don't we? We want the recognition. We want the nice house. We want the record contract without having to put in the hard work and the practice and the rehearsals. We just want people to recognize how awesome and amazing we are and then just shower us, with all the material blessings. In short, what we want to do is we want to put the cart before the horse. You've heard that expression before. Don't put the cart before the horse. I think that's what this proverb is talking about. Prepare your work outside and get your fields ready. Afterwards, build your house. Because you might start building your house and then realize, I don't have anything to support. I don't have any income to support this. I should have built my fields first. So my affirmation for today is, I put the cart after the horse. You could say, I put the horse before the cart. Either one would be fine. I put the cart after the horse. I put the horse before the cart. You get the point. That's my takeaway, my affirmation from today. Now what I want to do is I want to take a look at my guest response. This is from Charles from Surprise, Arizona. We've heard from Charles previously. Let's take a look at what he has to say. He says, the book of Proverbs itself is known as one of the three books of wisdom. In this particular chapter, I believe it is all about wisdom and the resilience of the righteous. For example, in Proverbs chapter 24 and verse 16 in the New Living Translation, it says, the godly may trip seven times, but they will get up again. But one disaster is enough to overthrow the wicked. Ultimately, this should give us assurance to the righteous, because Christ, who began a good work in us, will complete it at the day of his return. And that's from Philippians chapter 1, verse 6. We can use that confidence to strengthen our resolve to never give up. In the end, the righteous person of God will not be defeated. Even when they fall, they will get back up. Well, Charles, I really appreciate you sharing this perspective and this takeaway. Now, Charles didn't have actually an affirmation, so I'm going to just throw one in there for him. I'm sure he won't mind, and I think it's kind of appropriate. I get knocked down, but I get up again. I'm sure you saw that coming from that song, I get knocked down, but I get up again. All right. Well, thank you, Charles, for chiming in. Hopefully you didn't mind me adding a little affirmation there, having a little fun with this. I hope we're having fun. I mean, I think that's kind of what the, I think, what is it, a psalm? It's either a proverb or a psalm that says, the righteous can sing and be glad. That's the whole point of all of this is not to just kind of like, oh, we got to do this, but we consume this stuff and we process this stuff and we think about this stuff because we want to sing and be glad. We want to be happy. We want to have fun. We want to have an enjoyable life. And I think that's what God wants for us as well. And that's why he's given us this book of wisdom. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. If you have any questions or comments, would love to hear your thoughts, your takeaways. Consider leaving a comment or reaching out. There's information on how to contact us in the description area. Also some more information about the lesson in our description area as well. So check that out. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll catch you back here again tomorrow. Take care and have a great rest of your day.